this is part of a dragon because a client wanted a Welsh connection on this headstone. And they didn't want a conventional dragon, so I designed this one especially for them. So it's very stylized, because I think this type of stylization suits the lettering better than if it was a conventional dragon, because then it would look like a stamp on it rather than a bit of a carving, I hope. But what's nice about this type of dragon is you don't have to worry too much about people complaining that it's not the authentic one. So it's much better in that respect. Gives me a little bit more freedom. Now, you might be wondering, as I mentioned earlier, why this is not a conventional dragon. And as I said earlier, I think this type of thing reflects the qualities of the lettering a bit better. But the reason I haven't done it the typical Welsh dragon is because I hope the purists in Wales won't disown me for saying this thing. But, you know, I think Wales do even better in rugby than they are doing, although they're doing very well at present, but they would even do better still if the Welsh dragon or the Welsh flag was a little more vicious. It's like a pussycat, hardly no teeth at all, and the purpose of the dragon is to defend our nation. And who's going to be frightened of our dragon on the Welsh flag? It has no strength in it, it has no viciousness. So I'm trying to get a bit of viciousness into it, because I want this dragon to defend the country, not to be there like somebody to stroke. Otherwise, I might have put a cat in there. So I don't know what the purists would think of that. Oh, but the Welsh flag, the Welsh dragon is a beautiful thing, but it needs more punch. So I hope I've achieved a little bit of more viciousness in that. I'd like to think that this chap will snap his finger off if I've done it correctly. It's not that I'm a vicious person, but I think the dragon needs to be a little bit vicious. Lots of people ask me, you know, how I go about getting the design onto the site and what are the various processes in the design. I really don't know what I'm doing at the very beginning, because I don't know what the problems are. I'm not quite sure what the needs are, but once I get all that in my head, then all the work starts with scribbles on paper, always has been. You can't beat pencil and paper to get the initial designs going. I will do hundreds. And I literally mean it. This design there, for example, I don't know how many designs are made of it, but dozens and dozens, definitely. And because you're not sure which way to go, shall I bend this way, shall I bend it that way? And the best way of doing this is to do it, to find out. And if it doesn't work, do another one. And have the patience and the sticking power to stick with it until something begins to work. Now, when it gets to that scale, depending on the kind of work it is and the purpose of it, I might scan it into my computer sometimes. Because a computer, I don't think, distracts from the craft work at all if you're in control of it. And help, the computer then can make things heavier, thinner, sharper. And it can save the client a lot of money, because I can get so many alternatives very, very, very quickly. But once I've decided which is the right one, then I make the final drawing by hand. So it starts by hand and it finishes by hand. But often the computer will do the variations in between. Then I get it onto the slate, trace it through very often through a tracing paper or the kind of thing you have in, what do you call these things? Carbon papers, I'll get that involved in a minute. And then I'll scratch the design afterwards. But I'm not following the lines, they're just there as a guide. That's the important thing. They're just there to tell me what my extremes are. But I let my eye make the final cut. So if I'm cutting this now and I don't like what's happening, I'll change it. So it's being drawn by the eye at the very last minute. Or if my wrist tells me, no, I can't do that, I will respect it and modify things. So it's you're involved, in other words, right to the very last second. So the design is not finished until the last tap has been made. And then you'll see I go back quite a lot. The trouble is you can get in there and get carried away. and it looks very nice to you. Then you step back and say, oh my God, it's too thin, it's too heavy. So I have to see it in relationship to the whole. And this is another thing I always say to students, they don't like it. I tell them, get your bums off that chair. I think it's so important. They sit in front of the damn computers, they visualize things from the few inches between where they're sitting on the screen or the drawing if it's on a piece of paper. And they don't see the whole. And I'm a firm believer they have to get off their chairs and view it from a sensible viewing distance that the public might see it. Otherwise, it doesn't work.